Damaging winds and brutal rain. Australia's southeast, New South Wales, Tasmania and Victoria in the firing line. In Tassie, nearly 100 homes in the state's northwest are facing inundation.
There have been a number of places which have recorded 24-hour rainfall records for October.
The SES has received 120 calls for help, with another 100 millimetres of rain set to fall.
We expect the conditions to continue to deteriorate even once the front has passed. The soil is saturated already. We're going to see floods rising.
In New South Wales, the search continues for a man missing in floodwaters in the state's west. It too bracing for yet more flooding. While in Victoria, the SES has already had more than 1,600 calls for help and 23 flood rescues.
The rescues that have had to be undertaken, that number keeps going up minute by minute.
We don't want to see any more. If you attempt to drive through flash flood waters, it could be the last decision you make.
In Rochester, in central Victoria, a 1-in-50-year flood event is closing in.
That's where we could see up to 700 properties that become isolated and 250 properties that could see flooding above floor.
Residents desperately sandbagging their homes, the area expected to be cut off from the south tomorrow.
This is very serious. This will finish up being one of the most significant flood events we've had for quite some time.
The flood threat expected to linger for weeks to come.
It is important for Victorians to be reminded that this will not be the only event. We could be confronted with these situations over the next 6 to 8 weeks.
For a rain-drenched southeast, a tense 24 hours lies ahead.
Well, meteorologist Nate Byrne is taking refuge in his home office tonight. Nate, this has been a pretty big day so far, but how much worse is it going to get for Tassie and Victoria tonight?
Tonight is going to be the test. We've had a little bit of a break here around Melbourne, actually, for the last few hours. But things just intensified, probably within the last hour or so, a band of rain really pushing through. Tonight, we're going to see it shifting slowly eastwards through Victoria, certainly, but Tasmania's north. It is going to be relentless. We're already looking at totals since 9 a.m., pushing towards 100 millimetres in some parts in the north of the state. That's over like 9.5 hours. This is heavy rainfall, and the rivers have responded so quickly. In northern Tasmania, widespread major flooding already. And in Victoria, flash flooding, and we're seeing those rivers picking up as we speak, particularly around places like Seymour and Euroa. Communities are going to be cut off. Roads are already closed. It is going to be a wild night.
Nate, for New South Wales, meantime, the rain has been absolutely relentless. What's next for them?
Lisa, they're still copping it now in the south. And actually, at the moment, we're not really looking at too much heavy rainfall, but the rivers are still rising. Of particular concern right now is Forbes, where the water's just been creeping up and up, and we're likely to see it reaching major flood levels later tonight. But there is, through the outlook, even more rain on the way, believe it or not. The next system, we'll see it picking up Tuesday into Wednesday and then shifting eastwards into northern New South Wales and Queensland. So the focus a little bit different from the rainfall we're seeing right now. But those rivers, they can't take any more. In fact, in Queensland, we're spilling dams. In Victoria, we're about to see dams spill for the first time in 30 years or more. This is a widespread La Nina series of events, and there is no relief in sight.
Now, we have had an update from the Weather Bureau on La Nina. Mm. Now, please tell us, is this good news, Nate?
Come on, Nate.
I don't like to be the bearer of bad news, but it is so often my job. Essentially, no. La Nina is going to last through until early next year. And the Indian Ocean Dipole is also lasting until at least the end of spring. There is a lot more rain on the way. Look, fingers crossed, this could last for a lot longer if it was a much stronger La Nina. So at least there's that. But right now, like, we're seeing flooding picking up with 20, 30 millimetres of rain. Normally, in any other year, that's a rainfall. It would be a very wet day, but it wouldn't turn into an emergency. But the situation we're at right now, there's nowhere for the water to go. You know, so it just ends up as water on the ground, and the flash flooding that we're seeing, and these riverine rises that are just creeping up so quickly, and it's surprising so many communities.
We're blaming Nate for this, right?
Yeah. Why not?
No. You can blame me for sunrise, never for disaster.
Lovely to see you, mate. Take care.